and welcome to latest TV news. I'm Andrew Kay, and here are my top tips to keep you entertained tonight, plus a catch-up with Christopher Gull, chair of the Rainbow Fund. But staying with LGBTQ plus news, New Writing South and Marlborough Productions present The Coast is Queer, Brighton and Hove's Festival of LGBTQ plus Literature, which is returning this weekend for an in-person festival from the 7th to the 9th of October. Now in its third year, The Coast is Queer brings together writers, performers, academics, activists and, of course, readers for 3 days of lively in-conversation events, workshops, films and discussions celebrating queer lives and writing. Speakers for 2022 include Travis Albazanza, Julia Armfield, Michael Cashman, Juno Dawson, Leone Ross, Sara Winman and Hugh Lemmey and Ben Miller, authors of Bad Gays, A Homosexual History. Here they are at the Edinburgh Lodge of their book.
Revisionist history, part historical biography, and based on the hugely popular podcast series Bad Gays, subverts the notion of gay icons and queer heroes and asks what we can learn about LGBTQ history, sexuality, and identity through its villains and baddies. From the Emperor Hadrian to notorious gangster Ronnie Cray, one of my faves, the authors excavate the buried history of queer lives. So, should we get into it?
Let's get into it. Hi, everybody. Thank you all so much for coming out tonight. Before I start reading, I want to thank a few people. Leo Hollis, our wonderful editor, without whom the book would not be the shape that it was. Nikki Chang, who sold the book. Jordan Taylor-Jones and Jenny Tai, who are helping us sell the book. Thank you also, Jenny, if you're watching, for booking us in the funniest hotel I have ever seen. We'll tell you about it at the signing table afterwards. Thanks also to Eris for hosting the event, Lighthouse and Assembly for having us here, and everyone working the event tonight and at the shop. And of course, all of you for coming and everyone who's watching online. It's really incredible to have an audience like this, and this kind of trust is very much appreciated, always on loan, and we hope to keep earning it. So thank you very much.
Now, Lord Michael Cashman is a founding member of Stonewall, the LGBTQ plus lobbying organisation, but is equally known for that very first gay kiss on a British soap. Here he is, having just received the NatWest Bank Lifetime Achievement Award.
Here am I in my 69th year, although somebody said to me, Michael, that's not an age, honey, that's a position. But in my 69th year, in a world that is so much better for lesbian, gay, bisexual, trans, plus people. Did I ever imagine it could be like this? Yes, because for me, equality is the norm. Those who argue for and promote inequality, to me, are perverse. During most of my life, I've lived in the face of discrimination. That awful, awful thing 32 years ago when the government brought in the first anti-lesbian and gay law in 100 years. On the back of AIDS and HIV, which was depicted as a gay plague by some journalists who are still going today. I never believed that that would happen in my lifetime, but when it did, I knew that we had to pick up, in a strange way, a kind of legacy from over 1,000 generations of lesbians and gay men and bisexuals and trans people and anyone who was different, and our straight allies who, across those thousands of generations, stood up and said, no, you can't do this. And they lost their livelihoods, sometimes their families, and sometimes their lives. So we've come on an amazing, amazing journey, and it's been with sacrifices. Now, I'm a born-again optimist, but I want to say this. I think we're living in rather dangerous times. There are attacks on trans people, and the fact that those attacks are equally supported by lesbian, gay, and bisexual people is not only regrettable, but it's deeply, deeply reprehensible. If we don't stand with the most disrespected, the most defamed, if we allow their rights to be peeled away, then the 1930s reminds us that very soon our rights will follow. So imagine you are different. Imagine you're that trans woman trying to live her life, trying to be herself. That trans teenager, that lesbian, gay, or bisexual person on the edge of a community. And not the fear they face. It's not homophobia. It's homo-hatred. Let's call these out their hate crimes. Imagine living with that misrepresentation, that defamation, that hatred, and what it does to you. And if you wouldn't want it to be right for you, then how dare we allow it to happen to others? I never thought this far down the road, still battling for equality, that I would see the BBC issue guidelines to news and current affairs staff about attending such marches as Pride or Black Lives Matter, or that there'd be a fight around relationship and sex education so that it is truly inclusive. These are powerful reminders. Let's be on our guard. Let's celebrate. Let's recognise what all those thousands of generations have done. But a lifetime achievement, well, those of you who know me know my mantra is, we achieve together, only together. So this is yours.
A tireless campaigner for LGBTQ plus rights, he will be speaking at the Coast is Queer at the Attenborough Centre for Creative Arts this weekend. And that's it for the first half, but join me after the break when I'll be back with latest LGBTQI plus news and talking to Chris Gull in Valencia about the role of the Rainbow Fund and what the future holds for the city's LGBTQ plus fundraising body.